Inside. Oh, watch yourself, though. Let's have you leave here alive.
Hello.
Oh, hello. Whew. Sorry I'm in a bit of a tizzy. I was just scolding some of the plants for spitting and nipping. I suppose it's my own fault for putting more than four to a tray. By the way, Beatrice Green is the name, but you may address me as Madam Green. Welcome to Dogweed and Deathcap. Oh, mind you don't knock the mandrakes. Oh, if there wasn't the constant demand for antidotes, I wouldn't need to stalk so many of the little dears. Except, of course, for curses. And, well, if you've been petrified, then obviously you've come to the right place. Mind you don't knock the mandrakes. Or if there's an uprooting, you'll be the next one to drop dead, and I'm in no mood for a clear-up.
What do you have for sale?
Oh, I'm always thrilled when a young one makes a wise purchase. I can tell you'll go far.
Adelaide Oaks, isn't it? I received your owl.
Yes, I'm Adelaide Oaks. Oh dear. You see, my uncle Roland is a metal trader who's quite well known in the goblin community. He normally sends me owls every week when he's on his business travels. In his last owl, he alluded to dealings with those radical goblins, Ranrock's loyalists. It's been ages since that owl and I'm worried. What with the troll attack on Hogsmeade and the rumors that goblins may have been involved, well, I'm fearing the worst. Should I be worried about my uncle, or am I overthinking this?
I think you're right to be concerned, Adelaide. Your uncle may be in trouble.
You're much more understanding than Professor Weasley. She heard I was going to look for him and forbade me from leaving the grounds. She's convinced he can handle himself, but I can't concentrate on anything until I know he's all right. Could you try to find out for me? From what I hear, you're almost as adventurous as Uncle Roland.
I'll try and look into it for you, Adelaide.
Thank you. He's very thorough in his record keeping. Notes all his trades in a journal, makes maps. In fact, in his last owl, he drew me a map of his next stop. He'd planned to set up camp north of here. I do hope you're able to find out where he is. Thank you again for any help you can provide.
Could this be Mr. Oakes's campsite?
And what over here?
Said that her uncle kept notes of his trades, maps. Perhaps these landmarks will lead me to him. Mr. Oakes's trade journal. Mr. Oakes's trade journal. This looks intriguing.
Potato! Confringo!
Thank you. cook. Can't say I do. All a bit of a flurry of chicken.
Everything's all right now.
In mistakes, but I can't complain. If I'm to think on it, we've seen far. My ears.
What's this? A child on the door.
Don't think you're going to get out of this alive.
Don't do that!
Thank you.
I've completed my assignments, Professor.
Pleased to hear it. Professor Weasley will be too. I'll be sure to let her know how well you're coming along.
Thank you, Professor.
Professor Hecate tells me she taught you Levioso, so you should be ready for a more advanced levitation charm. Wingardium Leviosa requires a bit of concentration and a nice, graceful wand movement. Let's see you try your hand at it. When executed correctly, you should be able to pick up boulders as though they were sprigs of sneezewort.
Ironically, I didn't see ahead of time how bored I'd be in divination class.
Knowledgeable.
What do we have here? A demiguise.
I hope those assignments were challenging enough for you.
I've completed all of my tasks, Professor Onai.
Very well done. Although I must admit, I did have something of a premonition that you would follow through. Now, as you have no doubt sharpened your perception by completing my assignment, I am curious, based upon the knowledge that one's present and even one's past may reveal traces of what is to come, what do you see in your own future?
I can't get rid of this feeling of a coming danger.
I see. Know that such omens are not damning if they can at least prepare us. And you are preparing yourself even now. But this talk of tomorrow should not divert us from your present success. I shall inform our good deputy headmistress of your exemplary performance. And if that performance is any omen of what your future may hold, then I, for one, see great things. Channel your magic towards your targets. You have it. Now, why not practice the new spell on the training dummy?
Hey, you, Gryffindor.
There you are. The Crossbones Jewel.
Imelda Reyes? Albie Week sent me.
Did he now? Still tinkering with his broom upgrade, no doubt. I tried to help him once. He nitpicked my flying technique, and that was the end of that. The nerve. Why is he roping you into his broom testing silliness? You've barely started flying from what I know. Caught wind of you showing off in flying class with Clopton.
I don't know what people have said, but I certainly wasn't showing off.
Tell that to the rest of the school. But it doesn't matter. Everyone knows that class is only for beginners, troublemakers, and bumbling baboons. But for some reason, now people think you're competition. Ugh, I can't be having that.
Perhaps I am competition.
You're not even Slytherin. Could be a useless squib for all I know. Enough of this. only one way to find out who's the better flyer. I hold one of the fastest times on this course. Let's see if you can beat it. Slytherin versus Gryffindor.
Actually, why not? I can beat your record.
I'm so looking forward to seeing you lose. You must have cheated, you... Ugh! Fine, you won. Don't think this is over. You can't determine skill from one single trial.
Surely my win means something.
You're not terrible, but you're still going to have to prove yourself if you want to earn my respect.
Challenge accepted, then.
Perhaps you have what it takes after all. We shall see. But don't get your hopes up. The next course near Irondale offers a much tougher challenge. You can try to prepare by racing this course again. Just check in at the podium, where the leaderboard is. You can check your time and start the race. We'll see next time if your win here was more than just a fluke, whilst on an errand for Albie Weeks.
I never thought someone would ever best a Melder.
Harry, you're back!
With something to report, I hope?
Mr. Weeks, I was able to set a record on my broom.
Incredible! Miss Reyes must have been shocked. Tell me, how was the broom?
A little turbulent and is wanting for a bit of speed, but it fared well enough. I will say that it tended to drift a bit to the left on certain turns. Heard a slight swoosh when I dipped.
Oh, thank you. That's precisely what I needed to know. Drifted, eh? I shall get to work immediately. Even the naysayers will be forced to admit that my work's had potential all along.
I'm excited to hear more.
I have a very good feeling about this upgrade. I guarantee you'll be pleased. Expect to hear from me soon. How to address the issue of altitude as it relates to speed?
How would you like to learn the knockback jinx Flipendo? Once you've completed the necessary tasks, come and find me in...
Again, I've got spectacular news. The broom upgrade. Stop by the shop when you can.
And if you've been eating chocolate frogs, please refrain from touching. I suspect you have a sharp eye for fashion. Be sure to stop by whenever you're about.
Greetings. Please, take your time looking about.
Now, you let me know if there's anything else I can help you with. No one can say I don't keep a stacked shelf.
Anyone ever knew how to keep muggles out?
Hello there, come on in. Plenty to look at here. Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
Bertha teaching students jinxes.
You can't keep your eyes off a pretty lass, you can't. Quit a flick of a frock and you fall to punch. back for more.
Resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included. Come in. Sorry if there's a smell. No bats of toad hide. Seeing you here again. Consider yourself welcome.
Another way to
Take your time looking about. Plenty of wonderful books to stoke a curious mind like yours. Nothing like finding just the right thing, is there? Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
Everything's all right now.